Woman gets selected as chief petty officer, then they realize what she did. Her heart pounded as she raced to explain the story behind the pictures and posts her colleagues were talking about. It didn't affect her eligibility for her new role. He was cold-faced as he gestured to her to have a seat. She couldn't lose this job. It was everything to her. The only thing that helped her move past those dark days. But she had no idea what was coming. 33-year-old Kayla Rogers seemed like any other woman. She was hardworking, outgoing, fun, and kind. She just got married to the man of her dreams when her life suddenly spiraled in another direction. It's not often that you find people who lead two lives, even rarer is when they can keep them from colliding. But that was Rogers's specialty. After 6 months of studying and training, Rogers was ready to take her U.S. Navy exam in the hopes of getting promoted to her dream position as a chief petty officer. Just like all male-dominated professions, being a woman in the Navy is hard sometimes, and she felt like she had to train twice as hard to prove herself. And so far, she's been doing just that, but then this happened. For a while now, Rogers felt a weird tension coming from her colleagues. Sometimes she'd enter a room and the chat would abruptly stop, or people would simply leave. She put it down to paranoia at first, but then it happened again and again. Now, it was obvious something was wrong. They weren't telling her why and she didn't know herself. Suddenly, her stomach dropped. Driving in to take her exam, she wondered if they all knew. Maybe that's why they were talking about her. She felt like throwing up. She couldn't handle this, not today. She tried to forget about her dark past and focused on the task at hand. She sat in the exam hall for the next 4 hours, and painstakingly focused on one question at a time. By the time the exam was over, she completed all the questions, but with everything that was going on, she struggled to focus. Her nerves were too much to take. She ran to the bathroom to throw up. She composed herself and walked back out only to meet prying eyes. He walked up to her and asked her if she was okay. His eyes told her he knew what she did, he knew everything. Rogers walked around with a knot in her stomach for weeks. If only she could pass the exam and reach her goal, that'd be enough. So imagine her excitement when she was told she passed. She had achieved her dream of being selected as a chief petty officer. It felt like everything was finally coming together until she arrived to work the next day. As soon as she entered the base, she was called for a meeting. She had no idea what it was about, but she feared the worst, and judging by her boss's tone, it sounded serious. As she walked to the meeting, she guessed that word must have gotten to her boss's ear. She braced herself for what was to come. It was as she thought, word had spread about Rogers's personal life and the things she's been up to. Her luck of seeming to live two different lives would soon come to an end. Her heart raced as she began to explain that the pictures and posts her colleagues have seen and were talking about didn't affect her eligibility for her new role. This conversation was exactly why she didn't want to tell them. He gestured to her to have a seat. Once she sat down, she started from the beginning. She told him that she's doing much better. All of that was in the past. Things were getting better for her. She couldn't lose this job. Being awarded her new position was everything to her. The only thing that helped her move past those dark days. But what he said next surprised her. He stood up and looked at her, with piercing eyes he told her, "I can't think of anyone more deserving of this role. Everyone has a past, everyone has their own stories of hardship. I certainly won't hold this against you, and I'm just happy to hear things are looking up for you. But in the future," he said, "let us know. We can help." What happened? Kayla's colleague saw a post and photo she had shared to her private online account, where she announced that she was battling breast cancer. And doing so while studying and training to be a chief petty officer. Although she was open to her friends and family about her diagnosis, she wanted to keep her personal battles separate from work. To Rogers, the Navy was the only place she felt she could escape to and focus on something else entirely. She didn't want anyone to know, because she was happy to feel like it wasn't a big deal. But mostly, she was scared they would let her go or give her too much time away. If they did, she was worried she'd never achieve her dream of becoming a chief petty officer. However, instead of her boss and colleagues reacting badly and overattentive, as she thought they might, they completely surprised her. Her boss was overwhelmingly impressed by her bravery and that she managed to get through everything while going to chemo. She really had the mindset of a soldier, and her dedication proved that. Thankfully, Rogers got the all clear from cancer after a few painstaking months. Now, almost a year later, she is expecting a baby with her husband and announced it online almost a year after her initial diagnosis. "What the world says is nearly impossible, God says is possible," said her husband, Grayson Rogers.